Here in the heart of Somalia, girls have their genitals mutilated. These three survived the ordeal, but their 10-year-old sister did not. On the 16th of July 2018, Dika Noor bled to death. While Dika's story is common, girls have been dying of FGM for thousands of years. What happened next was not. Thanks to Ifrah Ahmed, an extraordinary anti-FGM media campaigner, Dika's death became the catalyst for change in Somalia. Ifrah is herself a survivor of FGM and made a film about Dika so her death would not be in vain. Usually a girl's legs are shackled for a month so that her wounds can heal. When Dika's bleeding didn't stop, they took her to hospital. Dika's story is an ordinary one. It only became extraordinary when Ifrah's film about her was broadcast in August 2018 across the country. It broke the silence that shields FGM, as this was the first time a story of FGM suffering had ever been seen on national television. Her message reached an estimated 10.6 million people across Somalia and was seen by millions more migrant Somalis across the world. The effects were immediate, giving people permission to speak openly about this taboo subject for the first time. Even the Deputy Prime Minister spoke out, ordering an investigation into her death.
The prosecutor has now appointed an attorney to investigate this case together with the Criminal Investigation Department. And this is really a defining moment for Somalia.
This will be the first FGM prosecution in Somalia, and the announcement made international news. After the success of her first campaign, Ifrah's second film gave survivors the strength to share their private trauma publicly on television. Ifrah's breakthrough on the media has led the way for some of Somalia's most powerful religious leaders, the imams, to join the fight against FGM. Now Ifrah and other FGM campaigners like her from across Africa, with the backing of films like this, are convincing religious leaders to call out publicly on the media for an end to FGM.